Hey guys, Pastor Greg Locke here. I want to be real and authentic for just a moment. I tell our people all the time, fixed folks can't help broke folks. And so I'm trying to be extraordinarily real in every area of my life, even from the stage and from these videos. I'm not going to fake it till I make it and put on a Jimmy Carter smile. So let me just talk for a moment about depression and anxiety. That's like the two evil buzzwords in evangelical Christianity, but it is reality. You read the Bible, there are people that suffered greatly, deeply, massively with depression and anxiety. Paul did, Elijah did, Moses did, Jonah did, a whole myriad of people. David did, when my heart is overwhelmed within me, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. And so some of you watching this, you feel dirty, you feel sinful, because like me, there have been times in my life in ministry where I couldn't get out of bed for days on end, didn't want to answer the phone, didn't want to mess with the kids, didn't want to just do the next thing because life was just a crap fest. And some of you feel like that. And here's what's wrong with those of us that have struggled with that. When people that love you most ask you what's wrong and try to get you to explain it, it ticks you off all the more, because explaining the unexplainable feelings that you have, the chaos within you, it's impossible and it frustrates you. It makes you feel worse than you already are. I know what it's like to have a full-blown panic attack 5 minutes before I walk into the pulpit to preach to thousands of people around the world, in a live stream audience especially. And sometimes we think, oh, we can't tell anybody. You better tell somebody. Here's what God tells us about it, Philippians 4:6. The Bible says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. You say, can you explain that? No, because Paul couldn't. He said it passes all understanding. There is a peace, there is a balance, there is a love that God gives us to silence the chaos and the noise within us. Be still and know that He is God. He will be exalted in your life in an unbelievable way. And right now, God is allowing some of you to experience some deep levels of pain and brokenness, because pain becomes your platform. Brokenness becomes your blessedness. So quit letting people tell you, oh, it's evil and demonic to talk about depression. It's evil and demonic to not talk about depression. It's the elephant in the stinking room, ladies and gentlemen. There are some people that just suffer with it, but we can get through it. If you're a believer, Jesus Christ is your hope. Let's get our nose out of the newspaper and stick it in the Word of God. The Bible has the answers. There's no doubt. People that have gone before us have struggled with anxiety, with stress, with depression. Oh, I know some people are like, oh, yeah, I just feel depressed. No, if you're depressed, you know it. If you've struggled with real major anxiety, major depression, you know it. Nobody has to tell you. It's not just something you pop a pill, pray over, and snap out of. It's deeper than that, but there's hope. Get up today. Get your blood flowing. Get your body moving. Get your mind working. Get your heart pounding. Hit your knees. Spend some time with God. Get in the Word of God. Bless somebody. Help somebody. The worst thing you can ever do if you suffer with depression is lay around in it. The best thing you can do is get up and go out and touch the life of someone else who's broken. So I get it. I really do. A lot of preachers will tell you that they do, but they don't, because you have to go through it. You have to walk that road. You have to walk that journey. I love you guys, and somebody today just needs to know it's okay to not be okay. Matter of fact, the letters okay make up the middle of the word broken.